Alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Brothers and sisters, it's my pleasure and honor to welcome you to another short episodes. We are dealing with the Quranic stories, and of course we are not making a detailed tafsir, but reflections, brief reflections. In Arabic they say lamhat, flashes of the stories. And today we are going to start with the story of Adam, and I will devote 3 episodes to it, because we want to see some of the important points that we can reflect upon. And then the 4th one will be the story of Habil and Qabil, the 2 sons of Adam. Now, coming as an introduction, let me invite your attention, draw your attention to what Allah says in Surah Yusuf, verse 111. لَقَدْ كَانَ فِي قَصَصِهِمْ عِبْرَةٌ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ مَا كَانَ حَدِيثًا يُفْتَرَى. Indeed, in their stories, there are lessons for people who reflect, who think. And it is not fairy tales. So, Quranic stories are intended to instruct us, to educate us, to create ideals, ambitions for us, and to motivate us to put them into practice so that we can realize the best of our divine potential. Now, coming to the story of Adam alayhi salam, in the Quran, this story has been narrated in at least seven surahs. Of course, various varying details. And I would start only today with the story from Surah Al-Baqarah, verses 30 to 39, and I will mention the first. It consists of 3 scenes. The first one is a dialogue between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his angels, and in this dialogue Allah states emphatically to the angels that what is his purpose for creating human being, Adam, and his offspring. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, it begins with وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَ إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةٌ. When your Lord said to the angels, I'm going to appoint a vicegerent, a deputy on earth. The angels are wondering why Allah would want to do that, when maybe from their previous experience, of another kind of creation, creating havoc and chaos and bloodshed. So the angels, all because of their premonition, they thought that this is not going to be a good idea, because they are going to create bloodshed and chaos on the earth. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells them, Inni a'lamu ma la ta'lamun. I know what you do not know. Of course, we are not going to dwell on the details of this dialogue, but the point we are going to emphasize, that the purpose of creation of man is that his mission on earth is to serve as the caretaker, vicegerent, or the shepherd of the earth. And human being has been endowed with the resources, with the inner capacity, with the endowments to fulfill this mission on earth. And so our purpose on earth is to act as vicegerents, or the shepherds or caretakers of the earth. Inshallah, in the next episode, we will talk about what potential, what endowment that human being has been endowed with, and in what way human beings is a distinct species. They are different from angels. In many ways, angels are purely holy. They do not think of sin, but human beings have been given that capacity to distinguish good and bad, and they have been given the choice. And if human beings exercise that choice well, and shun evil and go only for the good, they can even soar higher than angels. Of course, we will dwell on this in this next episode, the real endowment that we human beings have been given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whereby we have been given this dignity to serve as the vicegerents of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on this earth. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.